Hello students, today we are going to learn about the internet.
Okay, first let us start with what is a network.
For example,
children, suppose your family plans to visit your grandparents' house for vacations to spend good time with them. Your father plans to go via car. Since the place is far off and he wants to travel by road, so he will take help of Google Map, as it displays the areas connected through networks of roads. These networks help us in traveling from one place to another so that we can meet our friends and relatives living at far-off places. Now, can you tell me some other way to interact with your friends and relatives rather than meeting them personally? Yes, it is possible via computer or smartphone. Your computer or smartphone can help you in this task only if it is connected to the respective device at the other end. Just as a road network connects various cities and towns, likewise there exists a network that connects different computers with each other. This network is known as the computer network. Students, now let's see what is the internet.
When the computer networks are joined together, they form a bigger network called Internet. Internet connects millions of computers around the world. It has revolutionized the whole world and made computers the most effective communication tools.
The Internet not only contains huge variety of information, but also provides new ways of interacting and connecting with people. Students, let us study about history of the internet.
In 1969, when men walked on the moon, the US Defense Department sent an Advanced Research Project Agency, ARPA, for further research. They designed a network of four computers to exchange and share their data. This network was called ARPANET, Advanced Research Project Agency Network. Later, many universities were allowed to join this network and share the information. This was the beginning of networking of computers, which grew bigger day by day and gave birth to Internet, the technology which has radically changed our lives. Earlier, Internet was used by engineers, scientists and computer experts for research purpose, but gradually the network was made accessible to private agencies and general public. People started using it for sending messages and files between any two computers. In India, internet services started on 15th August 1995 through a government-owned company, VSNL, Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited. Students, let us talk about commonly used internet terms. WWW, World Wide Web. WWW refers to a network of sites on the internet which contains information in the form of text, pictures, animation and videos. This information can be accessed by people all over the world. Students, do you know Tim Berners-Lee is the founder of the World Wide Web? Web page. A web page is a digital page which may contain text, images, videos, audios, etc. Home page. The first page of a website is called the home page. It contains the main information about the accessed website along with the links to other pages of a website. URL. To visit your friend's place, you need to know his address. Similarly, to visit any website, you need to know its address. Each website is identified by its unique address, which is known as the Uniform Resource Locator, URL. The URL of any website is entered in the address bar of a web browser. For example, www.cartoonnetwork.com and discoverychannel.com are the URLs of Cartoon Network and Discovery Channel, respectively. ISP. ISP stands for Internet Service Provider. An ISP is a company which offers you the use of internet in exchange for a fee. It provides software, username and password to user in order to get connected to the internet. Some of the popular internet service providers, ISP in India, are BSNL, Tata, Airtel, Reliance, Idea, etc.
Students know the fact. The first commercial ISP was the Massachusetts Bay, the world founded in Brooklyn in 1989. Students, let's know more. ISPs provide two types of connections, dial-up and broadband. In dial-up technology, you have to dial a number of connect to the internet through an existing phone line. Whereas in broadband technology, a computer is continuously connected to the internet through the phone line. It provides high-speed internet access. Net surfing, the act of searching on the World Wide Web by following one link after another without a planned search strategy is called net surfing. Like the surfer of the water sport rides the waves towards the shore by going with the flow. Similarly, the net surfer surfs the ocean of knowledge, internet, by simply following the links. A link can be a highlighted text, a button, or an image. When we move the cursor over a link, the cursor changes to hand-shaped pointer. Clicking the link takes us to a web page in the website or to a different website. Okay, let me share the fact. Mark McGahill coined the phrase, surfing the net. Search engine. What will you do if you have to find a particular chapter in a book? You will see the index, find out the page number, and then directly open that page. Similarly, to look for any information on the internet, search engines can be used. A search engine is a software that searches various web pages on the World Wide Web for a particular information. It requires a user to enter a keyword related to the information to be searched and displays the search results in the form of a list of links to the pages on which the keywords are found. Examples of search engine are Google, www.google.com, Bing, www.bing.com, Yahoo, www.yahoo.com. To find information on the search engine, connect to the internet and use the desired browser. Open any search engine, example, Google. Type a few keywords related to the information you want to search, for example, Cartoon Network, and click on the search button. It will display a list of websites which have the relevant information. Read the provided information and click on the link you consider the most appropriate. The home page of that website will open. Students, do you know? Larry Page, right, and Sergey Brin, left, are the founders of Google. Okay, students, let us understand about the basic requirements for an internet connection. To connect your computer with internet, you need the following hardware and software. Modem. Depending upon the choice and preferences, a user can have an external, internal, or PC card modem. An external modem remains outside the computer. It is a box-like structure which is connected to the computer through USB port. On the other hand, an internal modem comes pre-installed in the computer. PC card modems are specifically designed for portable computers. They are roughly the size of a credit card. The speed of a modem is measured in BPS, that is bits per second. An internet connection. An internet connection is a service which an internet service provider, ISP, provides in exchange for a fee. This service is a must for accessing internet. Telephone line. It is a medium that is used to connect the computer to an internet service provider. Beside this wired medium, wireless medium, for example, air, is also used for the data transmission. Web browser. It is a software application or program that allows you to access the entire information available on the web. Students know the fact. Emoticons. Internet users invented emoticons, a combination of the terms emotion and icons, a sequence of keyboard characters that symbolize facial expressions, etc. look like a smiling face when you look at it sideways. All right, students, let us now talk about web browser and its parts. Google Chrome is one of the most popular and widely used web browsers developed by Google. You can open it either by double-clicking on its icon on the desktop or select the Start, then All Programs, then Google Chrome. Back. Clicking on this button takes you back to the previous page that you had visited earlier. Forward. Clicking on the Forward button will take you to the page that you were on before you press the Back button. To view the next pages in a serial order, click on the Forward button. Reload this page. Clicking on this button will reload the most recent version of the current page. Bookmark this page. This option allows the user to store and organize a chosen website so that one can revisit them whenever needed. New tab. Clicking on this button allows you to open a web page in a new tab. You can also open a link in a new tab by right-clicking on the link and selecting the Open Link in New Tab option. Customize and control Google Chrome. Clicking on this button will display a drop-down menu with several options to customize and control the Google Chrome settings. Some of these options are Print. Clicking on this option prints a copy of the web page you are viewing. History. This option displays a list of websites you visited recently. Zoom. The zoom option allows you to increase or decrease the size of the content of a web page. Click on the plus symbol to zoom in the content of the page and click on the minus symbol to zoom out the content of the page. Click on the screen symbol to select the full screen mode. More tools. Clicking on this option provides different options like Save Page As, Clear Browsing Data, Task Manager, etc. Best practices related to online safety. Protect your system. Use antivirus. Antivirus is a program that protects your system against virus. It identifies, prevents, and removes viruses from a computer. McAfee, AVG, QuickHeal, Symantec, and Norton are some of the commonly used antivirus software. You should always keep an updated version of the antivirus software installed on your system. Keep backup of your data. It is always advisable to keep a backup of your data on a secondary storage device. This keeps your data safe even if your computer faces a virus attack. Always scan attachments. Email is the most common means of transferring virus, Trojan, malware, etc. to your system. You should always run an antivirus scan for all the attachments attached to any email before saving it to your computer. Think before you click. While surfing the internet, you may come across several options. Be vigilant while selecting the appropriate option. Take the help of your teacher or elders while making the selection. Protect yourself. Choose strong passwords. Password is a safe way to prove your identity when using email accounts, e-banking, or your computer itself. You should always choose a strong and unique password which cannot be cracked easily. It should contain a combination of letters, numbers, and special characters. Do not give your personal details to strangers. Giving personal details to anyone over the internet can prove to be harmful for you. Your details can be misused by people with bad intentions for their personal benefits. Be careful when making friends on the internet. You can meet a number of people on the internet. Many of them pretend to be what they are not, so you should choose your friends carefully. Practice caution when shopping online. Always check the validity of the website you are shopping from. Be extra careful when sharing your credit card details or while making payments online. Okay, let me share the fact. Press F11 to enter and exit full screen mode in Google Chrome. Okay, students, let us take a recap of this chapter. A network that connects different computers with each other is known as the computer network. When the computer networks are joined together, they form a bigger network called Internet. WWW refers to a network of sites on the Internet which contains information in the form of text, pictures, animation, and videos. A web page is a digital page which may contain text, images, videos, audios, etc. The first page of a website is called the home page. Each website is identified by its unique address, which is known as the Uniform Resource Locator, URL. ISP stands for Internet Service Provider. It offers the use of Internet in exchange for a fee. ISPs provide you two types of connections, dial-up and broadband. The act of searching on the World Wide Web by following one link after another without a planned search strategy is called net surfing. A search engine is a software that searches various web pages on the World Wide Web for a particular information. To connect your computer with Internet, you need the following hardware and software: modem, an Internet connection, telephone line, and web browser.